All right, guys, so we're gonna do a little hip mobility drill here. I got my buddy Aaron over from Lebanon CrossFit, and we're gonna be talking about hip internal external rotation. So when we squat, we all have a different pattern. There is no ideal cookie cutter that we can all fit in, meaning the kind of ideal position where feet are forward, knees are forward, doesn't essentially fit for everybody. You'll find that certain hip anatomy will permit more external rotation and actually limit internal rotation. So you may have people that still fit the requirement where knee over foot, but the actual leg is more externally rotated simply because, again, hip anatomy. Now, regardless of that, it's still important that we practice healthy hip range of motion. So we're just gonna run through a hip internal external mobility drill. So we're gonna get ourselves into what I call the half W sit. So one leg is gonna be in front of you, just like this. The other leg's gonna be behind you, just like this. So for some people, this automatically is already pretty hard to get into, right? But now that I'm in this position, I've got one hip that I can explore a little bit more into external rotation simply by doing a bent over or almost like half pigeon pose. So bring yourself up and over that front leg. You should feel some tension kind of build up in the posterior hip capsule.
Check.
Yeah, and this is important because, mind you, that hip capsule, the bag that surrounds your joint, it's not a muscle. So it only becomes compliant for a small period of time once you put some load on it, meaning you've got to get the muscle to tone down a little bit, then you can put some stress on the capsule, but it's like a small window that'll close pretty quick. So anything you do to the capsule is really beneficial prior to the lift, but it's something you got to practice on a regular basis if you find that you have limitations. So in a healthy amount of hip external rotation in this position, I should be able to get my chest to touch, right? And now I should be able to come over my foot and again lay down on top of that leg there. Good deal, pretty simple drill to work on. Okay, now if I wanna work on the other leg, what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna sit up tall and I'm essentially just gonna lean back and you'll feel that open up into the groin. Now, mind you, if I shift myself over the leg, it'll load more. Shift myself off the leg, it'll load less. So this is one of those where you simply can just kind of hang back, chat with your buddy about whatever you did, if this is a position you want to be in the chat. But once I finish this too, I'm going to do some active stuff to make sure that what I just worked at, I'm able to hold on to it. So let's come back to this position here. Foot's going to stay flat. I'm just going to pick the knee up, bring it back down. So mind you, I could bring my chest all the way to my leg, right? Some of that came from the lumbar spine. But if I'm unable to bring my leg up towards my chest, this isn't a joint passive issue, this is an active muscle weakness issue. Should have enough strength to be able to lift my leg up this way, okay? Now for the hip, we saw that we can lean back on the hip. But we should equally be able to now pick our foot up off the ground. If that's really difficult to do, it's something to aspire to work on. It's just to get a little bit of rotation. If it's too tough, you can lean off the leg completely. That'll help you get a little bit more hip internal rotation. Good. You should start to feel a little bit of some tension up here on the top.
Check.
Yep. All right. Now we're going to combine these two motions together. So I'm going to take this back hip and I'm going to pick it up. I'm going to swing it around in front of me, externally rotate it, bring it down. Now I'm going to take this leg, bring it up, and bring it behind me. And I can do the same thing with the front leg and bend it. And then I'm gonna repeat the same process. All right, a little bit of mobility on this hip. Go the other way. Lean back a little bit. Each of these is typically about 10 seconds. Do about 10 reps of just picking the hip up. Go ahead and take some internal rotation of the hip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we're gonna bring that back leg up, swing it around, and transition. And now we're just gonna transition back and forth. One leg, bring the other one behind. Bring the other one up. Alright, so all the while I'm actually working on core, right, or trunk control, and I'm working on hip mobility. That actually has direct translation over to squats, deadlifts, burpees, okay? Now, while I'm in this position, here comes the last one. So now that I've gone and I've worked on some capsule mobility, I've done some active contraction, I've actually helped to move my hips throughout the space and keep my trunk balanced over top of it, now I'm gonna start working on what's called a half kneel. This is the end of what I'm gonna do for my mobility, because this is gonna really help to open up everything on the inside. So from here, I'm essentially going to come forward and up. Think about rolling the pelvis forward. You should feel that adductor, that growing area, okay? Now from this position, what I can do is I can transition to over here, tall kneeling, come up and down, come right back down, can bring that leg behind me, yep, come right back down into position. So basically, we're gonna get that leg out from underneath you. It's almost like doing a half Turkish get up, right, where I come up, forward, up, down, leg up behind you, come down. Easier on a softer surface. This is a pretty hard surface to do these on. But again, independently, that's one. And then I can include it with a step up. That would be two. And obviously using this on both legs, where again, I can bring that leg up, transition over, come up into that point, step. Yep, up, back down. Yep. Cool, good deal. And it may seem a little, maybe not used to what you guys are doing for hip mobility now, but the practical application of doing that, actually, in some countries that they use that as a measure of mortality. So your ability to get up off the ground without your hands shows to have some correlation between how long you live. And some of that could just be seen simply if we say, if I fell on the ground and I can't get up, I'm gonna need somebody to help me. And if there's nobody there to help me and I'm stuck on the ground, the likelihood is that I can't get help for myself either. So, you know, if you consider that some populations that have very, you know, aging people in it, learning this skill while you're young allows you to retain this skill. And mind you, even in your 30s and 40s, you're still young compared to people that are living into their hundreds now. So practicing that hip mobility drill will directly play itself out to squatting. And yeah, you can do things like push-outs or knee drives. Those things are helpful, but what seems to be the most helpful for really acquiring this position is understanding how to move your body through space, right? To have direct carryover to things like squatting, burpees, and everything. So that's one hip mobility drill that I like to use to improve squats. Why? Because I'm not just statically stretching. I'm actually putting some tension on tissue. I'm being conscientious. I'm recruiting muscle tissue afterwards, and then putting everything together from the ground all the way up so that that person is moving through space, their nervous system is doing what it's supposed to do, and they're actually physically warming up their body. This may be kind of tough for a lot of people to do, so I usually will say, start with your pigeon poses, start with your lean backs, do standard knee to chest, foot off ground, and then just transition into this single pose, right? Having that work its way into full transition from one to the other. And then if you've got some nice soft surfaces, just working on a lift out of that position and eventually to the step, right? Working from there. But it's always about being scalable when you do these things. So that's our video for the day. And we'll probably maybe shoot another one. We may be dressed the same, but it'll be for day 2.